With fall coming in, we all know things are gonna change. You know, we've got the transition happening, fish are moving in, getting into the interior marshes all over the place if you fish inside, and you know that. So what's gonna happen is we're gonna start having fronts coming through. Today's a perfect day. We got a front that just kind of passed through, not a strong cold front, but it's a cold front. And what's happening is we've got overcast skies, we had a little bit of wind the last couple of days pre-front, so now the front's gonna come through today, and we got some rain showers around. It's just a gloomy day. So you know in gloomy days like this, the fish normally will feed a little more active. But what I'm gonna do today, we still have a lot of bait in the water, but what I wanna do is I wanna show you what I would do when I'm out, and if I'm on a charter, or I'm fishing a tournament, or whatever I'm doing, how would I fish if I didn't have live bait? So what I'm gonna first do is I'm gonna use a popping cork. I've got a VersaMax Pro Series cork on right now, okay, the wired style cork. And then I've got me just a 3/8 ounce jig head. I want something that's gonna be down towards the bottom. And I got an H&H Kakahoe minnow, but my key is I'm using a Blackwood chartreuse. The reason for that is I've got overcast skies and my water's a little dirty. So I need something that's dark so it shows a good silhouette for these fish to be able to feed. Remember, dark days are dark water, dark bait, okay? So I'm gonna put that on. I'm gonna show you real quick. Everybody always wants to know how you put them on. This is it right here, okay? We're gonna put it on right in the front of the bait. Push the bait all the way up until it hits the straight shank of the hook. Once it does that, pull your point out. Come, push it all the way up on those jig head. And then that's you right there. We got that on there. Now we're gonna be popping a lot, okay? We're gonna try to trigger these fish in because the thing is we're using artificial. So using an artificial bait, we've gotta make a lot of action. So if I was fishing live shrimp, I'd pop the cork probably every 5 to 10 seconds. With this, I'm gonna be popping it, you know, every 3 seconds and double popping, single popping, changing up, making erratic stuff to be able to call them in to the bait. Once they come there, let's hope they eat it. I think everything will happen like that today, but I mean, we just pulled up, the sun hasn't even really come up yet, so we're gonna try it out. All right, let's see what happens. You ready? Okay. Oh, there he is. Oh, baby. Ooh. Now, using dark baits during days like this, you really think about the true reason why we're using it. It really makes sense because fish feed on a silhouette, like I said, and for us to be able to understand that is to say, like, okay, if something's up against the background and it shows a good silhouette, the fish can see it and they'll eat. So it works every time. Man, it's a nice little redfish right here. Wow, nice one. All right, dude. Now this was on just a blackened chartreuse Kakahoe. Honestly, I would say, let me put him back. He's got a little wound on his gill. Beautiful keeper, little redfish here. Remember, 18 inches in Louisiana. We're gonna put him back in. All right, buddy. But, you know, having this style bait, but I mean, I'm gonna look at my little tackle box here. Okay, that's the H&H. But like if I wanted to go and use, you know, either the mirror lure or I wanted to use a matrix, you know, they've got all different colors that are out here. Like I could use that dark purple, maybe this dark motor oil. They would work also. You know, one of my favorites is just black and chartreuse. It just always seems to produce for us around here. But you can use any style bait. These are minnow style, but there's, you know, you can get the ones with sparkle beetles, creature baits, anything like that is gonna produce these fish, you know, and it happens every single time. I mean, it works really good. But artificials, we know when water temperature drops, the fish tend to feed on those more. The size of your fish are gonna increase using an artificial bait compared to using live. And all of those things just kind of compile together in the, you know, the last quarter of the year. You know, that fall going into winter, those fish feed on those things, our bait gets less accessible and it works out great. That was awesome. I love it. There he is, boy. Now, one thing is, y'all have made about, I don't know, 4 or 5 casts and I didn't really get anything. And what I did was I moved and I made myself really tight to the bank. And I've got fallen tide. The tide's running along this little bank right here. Nice. Let's see what it is. All right, little redfish. He was really tight up against the bank. Ooh, he's actually like a little cool, believe it or not. Awesome. Look at that beautiful little redfish. That's our stock for next year. He'll be a good one next year. All right, now I want to show you how to rig up that I'm using, okay? You can go tight line without a cork. I'm using a cork right now. This is the Versamax Pro Series. The reason why I'm using this is because I want that loud noise, okay? It's got a concave face in it, splashes a lot. And the main thing is that I'm using a 3/8 ounce jig head. And the reason for that is that I want that to be down towards the bottom. The fish are gonna tend to get down to the bottom of the water column, and they're gonna be down. So I'm fishing about, I don't know, it's probably about 3 foot deep right here. I'm at about 2, maybe a little more than 2 feet, okay? And what I'm doing is I'm popping this thing a lot. So I'm gonna just throw it right here so you can see. But what I mean by popping is like pop, pop, let it sit for a few seconds, but I want to leave it in the same spot, pop. So I'm letting it just stay, but pop it 1, 2, 3 times and then let it sit for maybe about 5 seconds. Once you let it sit, pop it again, pop it again. You want to make that splash. You want to make that noise, because that's what's going to trigger these fish to biting. Because remember, we're using artificial, not live bait. We've got to call them in with sound first. Then in vibration, once they come over there, they'll see the bait, they see the silhouette, and that'll get them.
He didn't take it. Small bite.